Hello friends, welcome back to Fundo Tester. So in earlier videos we have created different utilities for REST API framework. If you haven't watched the earlier video, you can go to the Fundo Tester YouTube channel and under the home section you can find here REST Assured API automation framework. So in this video what we are going to do, we are going to test those utility. So in future we are not going to face any problem. So till now we have created extend report listener, file and environment. This class we are going to get data from the property file, and apart from those we have created API path and header config classes. So now in this video what we are going to do, we are going to test all these utilities. So first what I am going to do, I am going to create a one base class here in under my base test package. So this will be my base test, and here I am going to use testng. So first we need to write testng annotation, and I am going to create a one test method here, public void util test. So this is temporary method, anyways we are going to remove this. So this is, we are going to make sure that whatever we have written that is perfectly working fine. So first thing is, what we are going to test is our file and environment util. So in this util, if we go in this util, so the class name is file and util. Inside that we have created one static methods which is environment and file. So what I am going to do, so although this is a static method, so we can directly use with the class reference. So what I am going to do, file and environment, so this comes under the util package, yeah, dot environment. So this is my method. So this method will return me a map object along with this data. So it will return server URL, port number, username and password. So whatever data we have in this property file. So if we go to the dev properties, so we can find this information. So what I am going to do, I am going to simply print those information. So we can make sure that this utility is working fine and we are able to get data from the property file. So again, I'm going to repeat this. So we have here, we are getting values as a VM argument. So we need to pass VM argument as a DENV and value will be dev. How it will work? We need to select this class. So you can right click here, or you can select this class here and you can right click run as. So we need to first go to the run configuration. So in run configuration, what we have to do, first we have to select the project. So browse, we need to select valid project. So my project is REST Assured framework, and then we have to run my test class here. So we need to select test class. So this is my base test. So right now we have created only one test, so that's why it is coming only one. If we have multiple tests, so multiple tests will come here. So we have selected the class. If we are running the method, groups, package or suite, then we can based on that we can select any values. Now we need to pass VM argument. So how we can pass? So first thing is, we have to write hyphen DENV, because we have defined here. If we go to the, let me close this, I am going to save it, yeah. So if we go to the here, so we have defined here, this is env. So we need to write hyphen d env and value is dev. So I have to pass dev, either I have to pass QA, either I have to pass a staging. So what I am going to do, again I am going to run as run configuration. I have selected the value and I have to pass hyphen d env is equal to dev dev, and I have to run this. So whenever I am running my test, I am getting the same value, server URL, port number, password and username. So if you go to the property file of dev environment, so I am getting the same value. If I am changing here, so let me add something, test values, I am changing the port number to 8080 to 9090, test utils. So I have updated the property file. If I am going to run again, run configuration and run. We can see here it has added test value, port number it has updated 9090, username it is test utils. So our utility is perfectly working fine. Now let's say we need to run for different environment. Let's say we need to run for QA environment. So what we have to do, we have to simply update the VM arguments. Instead of dev, we need to simply pass QA. So it will execute our test on QA environment. So that is very easy, right? So simply I am going to run. Yeah, so I am going to get data from property file of QA environment. So similar way we can see here server URL, port number, password and username, the same data whatever we have defined, the same data we are getting here. Now there is one more thing. Let's say we need to get particular data. So how we can get the particular data? So as this is the HMEM, so what we have to do, we have to fetch the key. Based on the key, let's say my key is a server URL. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get environment and file dot get, we need to pass here a object key. So in object key we need to pass a server URL. So it is going to fetch only server URL. So let's say I'm going to run for again dev environment, dev and run. Okay, yeah, so it is fetching only server URL. So if I go to the dev property, so my server URL is https requires and /// values. So the same value I am getting here. But here we need to make sure, instead of passing this value server URL port number, we have to pass whatever value we have defined here, because we are fetching the key. If you are not able to understand how HMAP work, you can go to the YouTube channel of Fundo Tester and you can find inside the Java interview questions. So I have created one video which is how HMAP works internally in Java. So you can find it is very useful video. You can watch and you can understand how HMAP works. So this is how we have tested file and environment utility. Now we are going to verify further utility, it is working fine or not. So now first we are going to test header and config. So we have created header and config. So what we can simply do, we can create here main method. Let me zoom it little. Yeah, so I have created main method here and I have to create an object of this class. So header configs header is equal to new header config. And I using this, I have to call particular method. So what I am going to do, I am going to simply print those. So header dot default headers. So if I am going to run this, I am going to get those data. So in this method we have two values written here, content type which is application JSON and my test key and test value. So I am getting the same value. So if I am removing this, so now I'll get the single value. So this is easy, we can easily test this. Yes, it is perfectly working fine. So I am going to remove this. Now we have to test one more, which is API path. So in API path, similar way we can test here. So simply I am going to write a main method. Although this is my nested class and inside this I have this is my static nested class. So you have to, again you have to understand the concept, what is a class, what is a nested class, what is a static class. Although we cannot create a static class, but we can have nested static class. What does it mean? We can create an outer class and inner class we can define as a static class. So I can simply call this class reference. So simply I am going to print this value. So API path dot API path dot, I can simply call anyone. So let me call as a create user. So if I am going to run this, yeah, so I am getting a API user. If I am going to run delete user here instead of, so I will get API users /2. So let me run this. Yeah, so I am getting as a API /user /2. So this is, again, this is easy. Now, very important utility we are going to discuss, which is extent report. So how we can test extent report utilities? In base test, what I am going to do, I am going to extend our extent report listener class, extent report listeners, and we have defined here. So in extent report, we have method here. So it is starting with test, and we have to write like this, test dot log log test status, and we have to give particular status here. So simply we need to give test dot log, inside log status. So we have multiple log status, so log status, log details, log level, and log level. So again, here we are going to give log status. After that, here in log status we have different enum. So this is, again, this is the hierarchy. So first it will come info, then pass, keep, fail, fatal, or error. You have to understand the hierarchy of this enums, how it works. So what first we are going to do, we are going to give an info, and info, whatever message we want to pass, we can pass those message here. So here we can simply pass test has been started. Now after that, what we are going to do, test dot log log status dot pass, and we are going to give a message here, my test has been passed. So test has been passed. So based on that we will get the values. You can add any values here. So let's say what I am going to do, int a is equal to 10 and int b is equal to 20. So I am going to sum. So int sum is equal to a plus b. So this is my sum value. So let's say I wanted to add this value here along with my test result. So what can I do? Test dot log log status dot pass, and I'm going to here add as a sum value. So see, so if I'm going to add sum value, so it is showing me a compile time error. So change sum type to a throwable. So what does it mean? In extent report, we cannot simply add an integer value. So along with that, we need to add some meaningful message here. So my sum value is like this, we can add. So let me execute this, and after the ending of the test, we can add some another meaningful message. So test data info, my test has been completed. Let me run this. Run configuration, base test, arguments env, and run. So test is running. Yeah, so my test is fail. So what error I am getting? So I am going to console, and it is showing null pointer exception. So in line number 20. So line number 20, whenever it is going to write something, I am getting the null pointer exception. Why? Because we haven't initialized the listener. So what we have to do, we have to call listener wherever we are going to call extent report. We need to use listener, and inside that we need to pass this. So on top of the class, we have to write at listener extent report class dot class. So if I am going to run, I'll get status as a pass. So it is running, it has completed my test, and I'm getting status as a pass. So this is very important line. If we are using extent report anywhere, we have to compulsory call the listener before we are writing anything on the extent report. After completed my test, what I have to do, I have to refresh my project. So if I am going to refresh, I can see here inside the test output, inside the report, it has generated one folder. Inside test folder, I can see test report .html file. So we have defined the same path here. So we have given a result path to a folder name which is test result path, and we have given name as a extent report.html. So this is clearly whatever value we have to define, we can give a particular name, we can give particular folder. So all the thing we can define in extend report listener class. So if I'm going to open this report, go to the property file, go to the file location, and let me open with the any browser. So this is although HTML report, so we can open with any browser. So this is my unit test. So unit test is my method name. So this is my method name, which is unit test. So we can see here unit test. Inside this, whatever value we have logged, all those value it come here. So first statement is test has been started. So test has been started, pass, sum, and completed. So all these four value we are getting here. This 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is by default value which is come from test engine. So suppose my test is passed, then I'll get test is passed. Else I'll get test as a fail. So let me add failed statement here, so we can understand dot fail. So if I'm going to run this, so it is running, completed the execution. And if I'm going to here, let me refresh this file. So I can see here this is fail, and it has logged my this line. So it has logged this line because my test is fail. Like that it will work. Thank you guys, thanks for the watching the video.